Meanwhile, the Liberal Party is still hoping Vice President Leni Robredo will heed their call to run for president in 2022. That's as the opposition eyes forming new alliances with prominent political personalities for the upcoming election. Among them, Senators Vicente Soto III, Panfilo Lacson, Grace Poe, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, and Sorsogon Governor Cheese Escudero.
Politics is the art of the possible, diba? What if we all agree to set aside our differences and say that because COVID is the number one challenge for the next, diba, for the next administration, and the economic crisis will not get better before it gets, sabi nga lang, will get worse before it gets worse, we have to come together, agree on a common agenda.
President Rodrigo Duterte says he's seriously thinking about running for vice president in 2022. That's the second time in a week that he has floated the possibility. But Duterte says he would prefer to become second in command if an ally inherits the presidency.
If I run for vice president, tapos ang presidente na elect, hindi ko kaibigan. The situation would arise na sabi ko I would remain an inutil thing there. Kasi pag wala kang ano sa presidente, suporta, wala ka talaga. Ito ang dilemma ko.
Consider me last. I am not interested to run for the presidency. Yung tira na lang po yung akin kung wala na talaga kayong ibang mahanap.
The ruling PDP Laban Party in full support of Duterte if he does decide to join the vice presidential race.
Gusto nila na ipagpatuloy ninyo ang mga programang pang-ekonomiya at mga proyektong infrastruktura na naantala ng COVID-19 pandemic.
And I think you will again go to that place.
Yes, correct.
Before you decide, heed the call of your party mates, heed the call of history, and carry the torch of continuity as well as the call of national interest.
President Duterte also taking another jab at boxing champion turned Senator Manny Pacquiao. Duterte revived the 2013 tax evasion case against Pacquiao, which allegedly he and his wife Jinky owed government more than 2 billion pesos. This comes days after the lawmaker accused several government agencies of corruption.
I'll try to find out. May ano yan siya may utang 2.2 billion. Not because gusto ko siyang habulin, ayaw ko. But sabi kasi niya corrupt. Eh, di, kung corrupt kami, di, ikaw, when you cheat government, you are a corrupt official.
Pacquiao, who is acting president of the PDP Laban Party, has yet to respond to Duterte's latest tirade. He is currently in the U.S. training for his August fight against several Smiths. In business, Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte defends his decision to allow gambling operations in the country. Duterte once said he was against gambling, but he now believes those activities should be encouraged since government needs money for its COVID-19 response. Philippine offshore gaming operations, or POGOs, have been operating since before the pandemic. Last year, the country's anti-money laundering body flagged suspicious transactions, including alleged drug trafficking linked to POGO operations in the country. But Duterte did not order their closure.
Pagdating ng pandemic, naubos ang pera natin. May reserba natin, nagamit natin lahat to contain the viral virus from rampaging all throughout the country. Though it may sound not really repulsive, but maybe repugnant to lang, magdusa na muna kayo kasi kailangan ko talaga ang pera para sa bayan.